I waited until a few days before the end of the semester to register for the next semester's classes. I'm only going to take strategic management if I can, if it's the only way for me to get four classes. Well, I don't know. Let's see. I need to count the number of classes I have to take. I need to count. Degree. That was funny. I guess I'll just make a new notepad document. Although I could go back to my old notepad document. Let's see. Like degree or something. What is it called? Dang it. Oh. It showed up like 2 seconds after it. I don't know how accurate this thing is, but I can, like, delete the four classes from this semester. And then I have to count the number of classes that are remaining. Come on, open. Okay, hey, look! Look at that. Those two classes are going to be done. I took organizational behavior over the summer, and I took business analytics this semester. So I can delete those. I'll just remove them from the list. So there's only one business administration class left. Intermediate accounting 1 will be done, so I can delete that. Accounting information systems will be done, so I can delete that one. Federal income tax will be done this semester, and cost audit managerial law. Oh, I don't want to take managerial law. No. Okay, gender studies is done. Because I took the management gender and race. So, how many courses are left? This, I can delete the number 8. So let's see. We have the total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 classes left. Huh. That means I only have to take 4 classes per semester? Wait, that's surprising. What? And I could even take 3 classes one semester. That is very surprising. I have way fewer classes than I was expecting, according to this sheet of paper here. But let me just double check. So according to this, I only have 7 classes. Strategic Management, Intermediate Accounting 2, Advanced Accounting 1, Cost Accounting, Auditing 1, Managerial Law, Elective Accounting Course. And this does not include internship. But anyways, that's 7 courses. That's only 7 left. That's actually insane. That'd be, you know what I could do? No, I couldn't, because I can't take them all at once, because a couple of them are... Intermediate Accounting 2 is a prerequisite for Advanced Accounting 1. But for every other course, I think I have the requirements. There's only one course left that requires a prerequisite that I have not yet completed. What about auditing? Can I take auditing? 1? But anyways. So, electives. Oh, jeez. So, according to this, business required core needs to be finished. It says Microsoft Excel for business. So I think they should waive that one or whatever, because like I talked to my advisor last time and she said that I didn't need Microsoft Excel for business because I already took a Microsoft applications class like 2 years ago. Like, I would have needed this class for business analytics. So I'm going to assume I don't need that one. Strategic management. So, yep, I was correct that that's the only business administration class left. And then accounting. Oh, my goodness. Oh, wait, that's just... okay. There's required accounting core. Intermediate accounting 2. Advanced accounting 1. Cost accounting. Auditing 1. And advanced business law. Oh, no. Wait, what? Wait a minute. Advanced business law? Oh, you've got to be kidding me. How did I miss that one? There's no way. There's no way. Did they change it from managerial law to advanced business law or what? I'm confused. Okay, so we need one. We need one accounting elective, right? I only need one. Because I've already taken two, or maybe one. But I need a total of just one elective, right? Let's see. Choose 6 credits from the following. Yes, it says choose 6. I've already completed 3, so I just need one more class. So of these classes, we have governmental accounting, advanced taxation, advanced cost accounting, and auditing too. So pretty obviously, I need to take governmental and not-for-profit accounting out of all those options. Because advanced taxation, I haven't even taken... oh, wait, I'm an idiot. I could technically take advanced taxation instead of governmental not-for-profit accounting, but I think I'd rather take governmental not-for-profit accounting. So, thank goodness I could take governmental accounting. Instead, I don't even want to take... if I had the option to choose between this and this, I would obviously take this one. Advanced cost accounting, I haven't even taken cost accounting, and I haven't even taken audit yet, and I don't know what all these stuff are. So, I think governmental not-for-profit accounting would be... and also my professor mentioned that class, and I actually prefer, like, my professor from intermediate accounting, I really like that professor, so if he's going to be teaching that class, I would like to take that class. And even if he wasn't, I would still prefer this class over advanced taxation. So, there's actually, occasionally, that's funny, but I don't want to take that. I can't take auditing two anyways. So it looks like I can take governmental and not-for-profit accounting. So let's list the possible classes I can take this semester. ACTTING 3070. Go. Jeez. Just. Really, dude? Put the actual full name of the course. Okay, so that's the elective. I'm going to say elective right here just to be sure. And then, so apparently I listed managerial law on here. Business Administration 3140. Let's see. So apparently advanced business law and managerial law are the same thing. Managerial law 3140. So dang it, I'm very disappointed that I have to take that. I do not like the law courses. I took business law like 2 years ago or something. And I heard students around me struggling with their other, with their business law course. So now I'm very worried about that, but I don't technically have to take this. Oh, it says I can only take it in the fall. Weird. Not sure why that is. I'm going to just list all the courses anyways, just in case. Like, what if the term is incorrect? What if I can take it in the spring? I want to be able to have the option. But I'll remove it from the list of possible classes once I am absolutely sure I cannot take it. But I don't even want to take it, so... But anyways, prerequisite is going to be Business Administration 3130. Oh. And I don't even know what that is. Dang it, man. I'm just going to pull up my list of courses I've completed just to, so I can look through and make sure I've completed the prerequisites. Academics, course, not grades. Come on, where's my courses? I want to see all my courses, dang it. Class information. No. I want to see my course list. I want to see all the courses I will have completed. Let's go in an order. So we have the prerequisite for advanced business law is 31, Business Administration 3130. So legal environment of business. So yes, I have taken that. So that means I have advanced business law as an optional course, although it says fall, so it's looking like not possible, but we'll see. Um, 3140 advanced business law. I'm gonna say fall question mark because it looks like it can only take it in the fall. And I'll list all the business administration courses in one, in like together, I guess. I don't know. Business required core. It looks like I just need strategic management and all right. No, dude, are you kidding me? I can't load bit strategic. No, why? Do you really have to do this? Do you really have to do this to me right now? I need to see strategic management to see if I can take it. Although I don't want to take it. Oh man, I really don't want to take any more business. I want to cram all of my accounting courses into one semester and then so that I could have a very nice, easy semester and then cram all of my business administration courses into another semester. Maybe what I can do is have like three business administration courses in one semester and four accounting courses in another semester. Or no, that's not possible. But because I only have two business administration courses left. So what I could do is take my three accounting courses, or I could take four accounting classes one semester, and the next semester is one accounting course and two business administration courses. That sounds great. That sounds awesome because I want to have another full semester of no business administration. Oh, that was funny stuff. It won't let me look. It won't let me look at the strategic management course. This is so annoying. Come on. Man, stop it. I'll just have to go to class information. Okay, so we need to go all the way down and find it. So it says, oh, man, I should have done it on this side. Dang it. Okay, this side that has the it listed. This one will go to progress. Man, stop being stupid. So strategic management is 4840. 4840. Please tell me. What on earth? My mouse just stopped working. You have got to be kidding me. Oh. Right. Do we have... So, please tell me this is for spring 2023. So it looks like, yes, 4840. It looks as if I can take the class this semester if I really want to, but I don't want to, probably. Holy crap, there's only one student registered for this one. That's awesome. There's an online version of the course, too. Oh, yes. Online option is awesome. So anyways, this, and... But I'm probably going to try to save it for the last semester of the course. Or, wait, college. Strategic management. Save. Looks like it's available for this semester if I want to. So, wow, I can't believe I got A's in every single business admins course. How did I get A's? Seriously? Marketing, human resource, legal environment, business, organizational behavior, corporate finance, microcomputer applications. Wow, look at this. All A's. That's insane. I want to see what my grades look like in accounting. Well, I only have like two accounting courses. Or not even any. But anyways. So I already got the elective done. So we just need to look through all the rest of the required accounting courses. And intermediate accounting too is clearly something we'd be taking next semester. It's not even a question. Accounting 3020. Intermediate accounting 2. And let's see, it says view multiple offerings. Don't glitch out again. Ah! So whenever it says view multiple offerings, it means it glitches out. So we'll just assume that you can take it if it says view multiple offerings. And then, man, this is so annoying though. Like, clearly, I have the prerequisite for Intermediate Accounting 2. It's not even a question. I'm not even going to look it up. Advanced Accounting 1 is probably, again, like, stop being annoying, dude. Stop. So, this, the prerequisite is... Oh my gosh, my mouse. I think I need a new battery. Stupid thing, it doesn't even show the prerequisites that are required. I definitely need a new battery. Because this is not working. AA. Thank you. Okay, so, I think I need to, instead of looking at the course, let's see, instead of browse classes, I need to look at course list. Let's see here. Course catalog, maybe, is what I need to look at. So accounting courses. So what I just need to make sure is that I have my prerequisites. So accounting 3010, which is another tab open again. Oh my gosh. Because I need to have another tab open for my course list. Let's see here. So 3010 is obviously Enemy Accounting 2-1, so that means I have the prerequisites required. Let's just look at all the prerequisites for every class that I need so far. So let's see, management, accounting issues for managers, accounting information, advanced accounting 1. So advanced accounting 1 requires a prerequisite of 3020, which is going to be this one. So that's pretty obvious. And then governmental needs a grade in 3010, which is intermediate accounting. So I'm good for governmental accounting. Cost accounting needs a grade of something. Computer, so I should have the computer one, and accounting 2020 is just probably management accounting. So there, we're good on cost accounting. Financial statement announcements. Advanced taxation needs a grade of something or better in 3040, which is, in fact, federal income tax. So we're good for advanced taxation. I could take advanced taxation if I really wanted to, but I'm going to skip it. Oh, maybe I should add advanced taxation, though, just in case I can't take governmental accounting for some reason. So ACTTING 4040 advanced taxation is an option to take this semester if I want. Advanced cost accounting, obviously I need cost accounting first, right? Cost accounting, yes. And then auditing 1 needs a grade of something or better in 3030, which is accounting information systems, right? So since auditing requires accounting information systems, so I can take auditing 1. Auditing 1 and auditing 2 obviously needs auditing 1. And there you go. Right. So it looks like I know which classes I'm able to take based on my prerequisites. Intermediate Accounting 2. So we listed Intermediate Accounting 2. And are we going to list Advanced Accounting 1? No, because... come on, stop doing that. So Advanced Accounting 1 I cannot take because I need Intermediate Accounting 2. Cost Accounting I can take. Did I add cost accounting yet? No, I didn't. ACCTING 3230 cost accounting. So cost accounting is an option. Auditing 1 is an option, right? Did I write auditing yet? No. ACCTING 4230 auditing 1, and then advanced business law. I am so annoyed by that one, but I did already write it down. And is there any of these that say fall? Let's see. None. The only one that says fall is advanced business law. And then what about strategic management? I could take anytime. So it looks like, according to this, I can take pretty much any of these classes, except for maybe advanced business law. assuming advanced business law is not able to be taken this semester. In fact, let me just look it up here. In the course catalog, because this course catalog will show you where is advanced business law. And here, B, business administration. No, not course catalog. We need course list. Here. No, idiot. Dude, oh my. Not course catalog. I need the browse classes thing. I need business administration. And I need advanced business law. Where is it? What is the number for advanced business law? 3140. They don't list it here. So it looks like I can't take advanced business law this semester, although I could attempt to take it, but if I had to choose, so I've listed here, well, probably can't take this, but there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How did I have 7 listed? Wait a minute, I'm confused. Is there 8 total courses? Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Hold up. Just hold up 1 second. There's got to be something missing here. There's got to be something missing. Oh, I get it. I put advanced taxation, but it's, I don't need advanced taxation. It's just an elective. So elective, right? So I need one of the 2 electives. So I need 7 total classes for the rest of my degree, which is very surprising. I thought I needed way more than that. But actually, my ideal situation for me would be to take 4 accounting classes in the spring and then take 1 accounting class in the fall and 2 business administration courses in the fall. So my ideal situation would be to take this one, and advanced accounting in the fall. And then in the spring, I would take government, intermediate to cost accounting and auditing. So I think I had chosen my classes. That was funny. So anyways, now it's time to actually register for the classes. Well, not register, but like choose, find my schedule for my classes, and then like, well, I don't know if I'm going to register or what. Like, what's the thing that he wants me to do here? Also, I don't know if there's going to be sensitive information shown here. So I guess it's time to just show this stupid picture again. So have fun staring at this picture. Just going to double check, like, what my advisor wants me to do. Because I think he just wants me to take a picture of my possible schedule that I've chosen for myself and then send it to him, and then he'll tell me if that's a good idea. But anyways, need to find that document that he... Oops, it's not a document in downloads. Where's the document? Where is it? How long ago did I download that thing? Yeah, I'll just download it again, whatever. So Robert Snyder is his name. I couldn't even remember his name when one of my professors asked me who was my advisor, and I was like, oh, I don't remember his name. I haven't met with him yet this semester. It's Robert Snyder. Advising.document. Well, I'll just download it again, whatever. I kind of respect this approach of we don't really need to have an appointment unless I absolutely need it. I can just send him the schedule that I think I want, and then he'll let me know if that's good or not. But anyways, Now, technically, I could take 5 courses this semester, but it makes a lot more sense to just take 4 this semester and 3 in the fall. That makes a lot of sense. Oh my gosh, advanced business law is not going to be fun in the fall. Hopefully I can take it in the fall. Dude, it's taking forever to open. Come on, dude. We are going to go to the website. Let's see here. Enrollment. Greetings. Pass academic requirements. Enrollment dates. Enrollment appointment. So, I mean, it's pretty much already, I already knew that information. And I don't think there's any sensitive information here. Let's see. Yeah, this is pretty not sensitive, so I can show a picture again. Dude, what if it shows my address, though, when I go into that one thing? Okay, first I'll go into the thing, which is edit enrollment. Well, not edit enrollment. I want schedule builder. I like schedule builder because, I don't know. Like, there's 2 different ways to do it. I don't know if Schedule Builder is the best way. Like, what's the best way? Schedule Builder or no? I'll try Schedule Builder. And fall. Okay, no, we obviously want spring 2023. So I don't think it's going to show any sensitive information. So the campuses. You know, I'll select all campuses and see what happens. Because I'm open to anything. Really, I'm just open to taking classes at Platteville and online. So maybe I should not have selected. But sometimes it will show you classes that are in another campus, but they're actually online, so it doesn't matter. He sniffed. So it doesn't look like it's going to show any sensitive information, so I'll show this again. That's fine. So the courses I would like to take are governmental, okay, accounting 3070, add course, did I add it? Yes. Out of the electives, that's the one I like the best, so. And then we have intermediate accounting 2 is 3020. And then we have cost accounting is 3230. Uh-oh. I can't see 3230. No! How come I can't take cost accounting? No. I'm so disappointed. I have no idea why it's not showing up. Man, I don't get it. It should have showed up. It should have. Cost accounting is right here. No, this is business administration. We need cost accounting. Hello? What on earth is going on? Oh no! How is it not listed? Wait a minute. I messed up. No. Do your progress. No. It's not gonna be all happy like I was hoping. Gotta be kidding. I was certain I could take cost accounting. Where is it? No. It won't let me expand. We have to go back to... Oh my goodness, no. How is cost accounting not available? Man. Oh. What the heck? If I go to the course catalog and go to... and go to cost accounting, will it show? No longer offered? They don't offer it? What? What? There's no way. There's no way. You have to take a course in a cost accounting at a different college or something? Like, what is this? Oh my goodness. They don't offer cost accounting. Wait. It's only offered in the fall. I think that's the only way you can take it. Let's see. It says distance learning is no longer offered. But the fall option is there still. I am so disappointed in this. I was so looking forward to taking that. Well, I wasn't looking forward to taking it. I was looking forward to not having to take a business administration course. Man. I could still save all of my business admin stuff for the next semester, but that doesn't make any sense because it makes much more sense to try to take four this semester just in case I fail or drop a class in this semester, then I can push it to the next semester. So it appears that cost accounting is only available in the fall. And that probably goes for advanced. Let me just double check advanced business law. What? Let's just check advanced business law too, which is probably also only available in the fall. Where's advanced business law? 3140. So it appears as if it's only available in the fall. No, nothing else is open in the fall for advanced business law, and we can even confirm that here. We can go to business administration and try to select advanced business law and it will not show up, right? Because it's 3140. Yeah, it's not showing up. Well, I hate myself. That was fun. Dang it. So cost accounting is only in the fall. And I hate myself. That means I have to choose either strategic management or advanced business law. Wait just 1 second. No. No, I don't want to take strategic management. No. No, don't make me do that. That's the only other option available. You've got to be kidding me. This is not good. This is not good. No. Every single one that has a parenthesis on it? No. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to just say, here's what I'm going to do. List the ones I'm taking. Copy. Paste. So I'm obviously going to take government and intermediate too. This is not looking good. It's looking like I might have to take strategic management. No, 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 no. You've got to be kidding. You have got. I don't want to take strategic management. No. No. I can't take cost accounting. Auditing. Am I forgetting something here? Like, can I take auditing? Let's see. Accounting. Auditing 1. Looks like I can take auditing 1. So auditing 1. And the only other option left for me, government, business law is in the fall. Here. Advanced taxation is not required. It's not required because I have government. Cost accounting is only in the fall. So the only option is strategic management, and I hate my life. You've got me kidding. That's the only way. I could just take 3 classes this semester. But it's much better to try to take 4 just in case I drop a class. Which means strategic management. Well, time to have the most miserable semester of my entire life. That's what the advisor made it sound like. The advisor made it sound like it's like the hardest class on the entire universe. Thanks a lot. Thanks for building my confidence in that class. I don't want to see it here. Please just not be here. Don't be here, please. It's here. Oh no. And also, do I have the prerequisites for strategic management? I didn't even look it up because I didn't think I was going to have to take it. I didn't think I was going to have to take it, but I have to. Well, I don't have to, but I probably should take it. No. Wait, why are there 2 different options? We have this one and this one. What's the difference between these two? The difference between these two is... there's a distance option and there's a main campus option. And if I had to choose between the two, I would obviously choose distance. Right? Or would I? Maybe not. I don't think I would choose distance because distance is harder. But at the same time, I don't have to drive to school every day if I take that one. But if it's on a day I'm already at school, then I may as well. So we'll see what our options are. Man, looks like strategic management is what I need to take. Oh, geez. And what's the prerequisite again? That was what I was going to look up originally. I need senior standing, which I should have senior standing by the time this I am able to register for the class. Accounting 2020, business admin 1300. What is business admin 1300? What is Business Administration 3620? Corporate finance. There's so many things. I just need to look at BBA and I need to see what courses I've taken just to be sure that I have all the prerequisites. I need County 2020. I probably have that already. I'm just going to assume I have it. That was Global Business. 2100 is Supply Chain Management. 2630 is Corporate Finance. I already looked that up. No, 2630 is Marketing. 3030 is Human Resource. And then 3620 was Corporate Finance. And Economic 2130 and 22. Where's the economics? Oh, wait. So I've taken both economics. I've taken financial management. Oh, man. There's pros and cons for it. In-person versus distance. There's pros and cons. Pros, distance, pros. Don't have to drive to class. Cons, there might be a lot more work. And then in-person, pros, might be a little bit less work than the online. Cons, I have to drive to class. But if it's going to be on a day that I'm already at school, then I may as well just do the in-person one because it's going to be slightly easier, I think. No. 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 Generate schedules. There's only two options. View. Schedule 1, Schedule 2. Right. Let's see. What's the difference between these two? Wait, why are there 5? I only included 5 here. What the heck? Huh? I'm so confused why there's... What's this? Okay, this is extremely weird. I have no idea what the heck that is. But anyways, we have a distance option there, and then there's main campus. Let's see what the main campus option is. It's Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. It looks like I'm screwed. Wait, what is it? And I have to go to school 5 days a week. I hate my life. That was funny. I have to go to school 5 days a week regardless of what happens. Well, dang my life. You've got to be kidding me. I have to go to school 5 days a week. Next semester. I have to go to school 5 days a week. Next semester. No. 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 You've got to be kidding me. The only difference is either online or in-person course. And that means I'd have to sit in a private room for an hour there. But I would still be going to school 3 days a week. anyway, or 5 days a week, regardless of whether or not I take the in-person version of the course. Do I want to take that one or not? Or do I want to do the main campus version? Do I want to do the in-person version of it? Or do I want to do the distance version? Could be better to take the distance. I don't know which one to choose. Oh. I have a feeling that the distance one's going to be harder. Choices, choices, choices. It will not save me any gas money at all to take the online versus the in-person one. It will not save me a single bit of gas money. However, at least I won't have to go to an in-person class and embarrass myself. And also sit in a private room for however long I need to stay in the private room for. Tuesday and Thursday. Well, at least I won't have to wait around forever in between these two classes. That's nice. What's the classroom it's in? Man, it's such a hard choice between live and not live class. But because I'm afraid if I take the online class, it's gonna give you a million assignments to do. Who's the professor for the main campus version? Does it even say? I don't think it does. The heck? Oh, Maya Chaber. I don't know who that is. Who's the professor for the online? It doesn't even say. Is there a difference between these two? I don't think there's a difference. Like, the only difference between the two schedules that I can see is the two different options for strategic management. There's either online or in person. I think I should do the online. Like, I can't anticipate which one's going to be harder. I just want the easier option. Whoops. So, if I went to the in-person option, that means I would have to wait around from 9:50. Oh my gosh, I would have to wait a long time. So basically from 10 to 1, 11 to 1, that's 3 hours. I don't want to sit in on campus for 3 hours again like I did last semester. And that would have to be 3 days a week too. But it was actually kind of good for me because I pretty much spent the entire time doing homework every time. Maybe I should do that. Yeah, but I'd rather just do my homework at home. So options. Either we sit around on campus for three hours, 3 days a week, and face the potential embarrassment of life, of what comes with going to a live class. Man, I wish I didn't have to go to campus 5 days a week. You gotta be kidding me. 5 days a week. 5 days a week. Dang it. Man. 5 days a week. Because of stupid, dumb, which class is ruining my life here? The class that's ruining my life is Auditing 1. It's with Daniel Nugent, which I like that professor, so maybe I could... Do I even have any other options, though? If I wanted to avoid taking Auditing 1 and instead take a different class, or what I could do is just simply only take 3 classes. Ooh. If I want to take 4 classes, I have to go to campus 4-5 days a week. But if I want to take only 3 classes, I could skip auditing and save it for next semester so that I could avoid going to class 5 days a week. But the disadvantage is that I would be taking 3 classes one semester and taking 4 classes the second semester. What if I go back to... They won't let me select fall 2023? Come on, I want to see what would happen if I looked at fall. I want to look at fall. Because I might just be simply putting off having to do that, having to go to class 4 days, 5 days a week next semester instead. It's like, I have a good professor for that class, so I actually would rather take the class than risk having a different professor next semester. Wait a minute. One schedule might have one professor and one schedule might have another professor. What if that's the case? No. Well, not for Intermediate Accounting 2 is going to have a professor I'm not familiar with at all. John Hammermeister. This one is governmental. Daniel Nugent for both of them. And then Daniel Nugent for Auditing 1. I'm afraid they're going to give you a ton of homework because it's online. They might give you a ton of homework to do because it's online. But I'm afraid of the in-person class because of all of the difficulties that come with going to in-person classes, obviously. So I think I might choose the distance class instead. It's going to cost extra, though. What's the fee? You could just tell me the fee. Oh, it's like $45. I don't want to go It doesn't save any gas money at all to take the online one, but at least I don't have to take the in-person version of the class. Because I don't want to take the in-person version. That could be bad. That could be bleh. That could be really bleh. So, I think I'm going with online for that class. But it still sucks. I still have to go to class 5 days a week. Because Monday, Wednesday, Friday, I have one single class. At 1 to 150. It doesn't save gas money to take what... My decision of whether or not to take the in-person version of this class does not affect anything. It doesn't affect anything. It doesn't make logical sense to be like, oh, you're already going to one class, so you may as well go to two classes. That doesn't make any sense. It's just going to be easier. It's going to be easier to take the online class, right? It's going to be easier. Why do I have to make a decision? I have to make a decision. Oh no. I don't feel like sitting on campus for 3 hours a day like I had to do this whole semester. Because it's very annoying to have to go up and go into a private room. It's not the most private. I mean, it's private, but sometimes I don't get the room I want, and it's kind of cold, and that was fun. And also, in-person classes are not fun. I'd rather take online. Sure, it might be a little bit more work, but it's not going to be that much more. What would you rather do? Sit in the private room for 3 hours and then go to an in-person class where there's lots of uncomfortable situations that happen? Or would you rather have a little bit more work to do, but you don't have to go to an in-person class and you don't have to sit in the private room for 3 hours, 3 days a week? Like, yeah, now it's going to feel weird to drive to school 3 days a week just for one tiny little 50-minute class. But I don't have a choice. I'd have to do that regardless. So it doesn't make a difference. It's going to be so fun to drive to school Monday, Wednesday, and Friday to go to one single 50-minute class. Isn't that going to be great? The only other alternative is to get there earlier in the day to have another class that's 3 days a week, and then have to wait for 3 hours on campus for my next class. So there you go. I have chosen. That was fun. I don't know what the heck this thing is. For some reason, why do we take exams on Wednesday from 5 to 7? I have no idea why. Whatever.
Alright.
Governmental and not-for-profit accounting. Auditing 1. And strategic management. And you know what I could do is I could save strategic management. Well, I could save one of two classes for next semester. I could save auditing for next semester, or I could save this one for next semester. And if I saved auditing for next semester, I could avoid going to class 3 days a week. And if I saved strategic for next semester, and it wouldn't really make a difference. There's no real benefit to doing that. I guess, I don't know. Saving auditing for next semester means that I could avoid going to class. I could
go to class 2 days a week. But that then I would only be taking 3 classes, which feels like not enough. But I would take the classes next semester anyways. And also,
that was funny. Certified Internal Auditor, Internal Revenue Service Enrolled Agent. Hours of college credit. I wonder if I have... I would end up with 150 hours of credit. Because general education... No... There's no way I'm going to end up with... How many hours of college credit did I take at NACC? Man, I wish I had my transcript from NACC. Because what if I ended up with 150 hours of credit just by simply having taken a million classes at NACC? You would think I would have it in downloads. Like if I typed transcript here, would I have it? No, of course not. No, I want my NICC transcript. I want to see how many credits I had. Man. Take another elective? I don't want to take advanced taxation. Credits must be completed to have a certification. Like, what other courses would be necessary, or what would I want to take? I hate the idea of having to go to school 3 days a week for one single class. But I have to take... I could avoid it if I only took three classes this upcoming semester. I could avoid it. But then I would lose my safety net because I would not be able to afford to drop a class. And it would also look bad to only take three classes. That's funny. Because I'm gonna need to take more classes. If I wanna get some kind of certification, I am going to eventually need to take more classes. If I really want some kind of certification. Okay. You know, here's the fun thing. Here's the idea I have. Instead of doing my current plan that I'm planning to do, which is going to class 3 days a week just so I can take auditing one. That sounds like bluff. That sounds terrible. What I could do instead is try to find another class that's on Tuesday and Thursday that is not technically a requirement for my degree, but it would help me get some credits that I could... It would help me with... it would help me, like... Let's see. I don't know what course I could possibly take that would help me with my 150 credits requirement for certification. Because, so this is what I'm gonna do. I'm going to, no, don't expire the session. So I think I'll give him this schedule here that I've constructed for myself, but I will also ask him if there's a possibility that instead of auditing one, I want to take another course that is not necessarily a degree requirement, like audit or like advanced taxation maybe, could be, ooh, I don't know, I want to take advanced taxation. Let's see if advanced taxation would be like a Tuesday, Thursday class. Back. Let's disable auditing one and instead add advanced taxation. Because that's like another elective that would make sense. But I don't know if I even want it. Well, I might not have a choice. I'm probably going to have to do a lot of taxes. As an accountant, I'm probably not going to have a choice whether I have to do tax accounting or not. So I may as well just go all in on it. What is the vibration going on up there? Right, let's see what happens if I have advanced taxation and not auditing. And let's see what we got here. We have Advanced taxation. Oh, it's a Monday, Wednesday. Not cool. That's Sayed again. Or Sayed. How do you pronounce his name? Sayed? Dude. Sayed again. There's no avoiding him. It's impossible to avoid Sayed. He's going to be in advanced taxation. Okay, so that wouldn't help me avoid going to class Monday and Wednesday. Well, it would help me avoid going to class on Friday. But that's about it. The only thing it helps me avoid is going to class on Monday, on Friday. So that's not going to help anything. So, delete that. Remove the advanced taxation. So instead of that, what could there possibly be? I wish I could take, like, another accounting course. Like, I can't take cost accounting. I'm so mad. Okay, what is that vibrating going on upstairs? Okay, so I'm just going to go with this schedule, and I'll ask my professor if there's anything I can do other than auditing that takes place on Tuesday and Thursday that would help me in the future for my future certification, but it wouldn't necessarily be required for my degree because I couldn't find any other options that would satisfy those criteria. Like, let's see. Managerial law, that's only in the fall. Cost accounting is only in the fall. Advanced taxation, I could take it, but it'd be a Monday, Wednesday class, right? That's the only way I could take that. Monday and Wednesday, so I can't. So the schedule I'm going to be going with is I decided to do the distance online version of strategic management instead, which is very sad, but oh well, can you please stop? There's no change between these two schedules. The only change here is whether I go to it in person. So this is what my day is going to look like. Wait, what the? I accidentally didn't delete the advanced taxation. Generate schedules. For a second, I was like, oh my gosh, I don't have a class on Friday. No, I do. Man, stupid Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So annoying. Man. Alright, so this is my schedule. Send to shopping cart. Well, not send, but like, I want to save this. Not print. I want save as a PDF or something like that. Email. I wish you could just... I'm going to save it as a PDF. I'll save it as a PDF. Save it to desktop. Schedule. Possible schedule for spring 2023. Okay. So let's see here. All righty. Now I will email, send an email, have fun staring at my ugly face. That's funny. Robert J. Snyder. Robert J. Snyder. Robert J. Snyder. Dr. S. You know what's funny? When I asked him about the advising appointment, he, you know what? I'll just show you the email. It's pretty funny. Whoops. Here's what he responded. Here's his response when I sent my email originally. See attached. You're welcome, Dr. S. Well, it's short and to the point, so that's pretty funny. Anyways. Where's the draft? So, advising. Oh yeah, I need to attach the PDF. For spring 2023. For spring 2023. They are I also have a question. So let's see what. I have one concern. With this schedule, I would have to go to class. I would have to drive 40 minutes. I would have to drive all the way, 40 minutes I would have to drive. Oh my gosh. I would have to go to class to, I would have to go to 150 minute class on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Which would, which is very annoying because I live 40 minutes away from campus. I was thinking, instead of taking auditing one, I could take some other course that is not a degree requirement, but it would help. It would go toward the credits required for getting some kind of accounting certification in the future. This semester, I could take some other course that is not a degree requirement, but it would go towards the credits required for gaining some kind of accounting certification in the future. That then I could avoid driving to campus 3 days a week. But still be able to complete the degree. By the end of the year. Because I have a footy. Okay, I need to mention that it's a Tuesday-Thursday course. Some other course, Tuesday-Thursday, that is not a degree requirement, Tuesday, Thursday, or online. It might be that no course fits this description. No course satisfies all of these criteria. Tuesday, Thursday or online and helps with future certification. Or that this is just not a good idea for some reason. And if so, then I'm fine with the class schedule I chose, I sent in the PDF. Oh my gosh, this is a long email. You know, maybe I should say I live 35 minutes away, because lately it's only been taking like 35 minutes to get to class. That was funny. Oh my gosh. Oh, come on, phone. You didn't notify me when it went to 100%. Okay, that was funny. And I sent the message. Gosh. Oh, man. So, And my other option, so here are my options. I go with the schedule I made. I go with this exact schedule minus auditing. And I go with this exact schedule minus auditing plus another useful course. But I don't know what that course would be because it's not any course that's a degree requirement. It would have to be some random course that would help me with future certification, but it wouldn't necessarily be a degree requirement. But I don't know how any course that would really work because, like, advanced taxation, I could have been that course, but it can't. It didn't work because it was only because the only time it was available was Monday and Wednesday. So I don't know what course would satisfy all those criteria. I can't have nice things, can I? That was fun. And that was funny, bye.